Training Solutions YouTube channel. Today I'm going to talk to you about a subject that I find particularly interesting, that's unqualified personal trainers. Hopefully you're not one of these as you watch this video, but if you are an individual that wants a personal trainer, what things you need to look for? Well, you know, why would you use an unqualified personal trainer? There shouldn't be a reason, but some of the reasons after speaking to certain people has been, one, they're cheap. So they're cheap, okay, that's good. It's good for you. You're not gonna get your goals. They're not gonna have they won't have the experience or the education level to be able to take you through your goals. I didn't ask for their qualifications, that was another one. And the third one is, I didn't expect anyone to be so misleading to me. So let me give you some home truths about the industry. There are a lot of unqualified personal trainers, a shocking lot. It's the way it is in industry. The industry isn't policed enough. So unfortunately, we do have some rogue personal trainers out there. Just because your personal trainer has uploaded their latest picture on Instagram, jacked on whatever synthetic chemical they're in, and they look good on stage, doesn't make them the best personal trainer. It means they're dedicated to get from a point A to a point B. And point A and point B brings me back to another goal. Not just unqualified personal trainers, but if your personal trainer is a good personal trainer, they will set you goals. Is your personal trainer setting you a goal? If they're not setting you goals, then you've got nowhere to go to. How are you possibly going to get anywhere with your program? So a true sign that you've got a rubbish personal trainer is that they're not going to teach you any experience with goal setting. They're not going to take you to the next level of your training because they're not going to have the education to. Or even worse, they don't even know what your goal is to start off with. You turn up, they take your money, they train you, and you go home. And you do the same thing the following week, having no idea what to do or what to expect during the rest of the week when you're not with them. So what about insurance? That's another thing no one thinks about. Insurance cover is another thing. If you're with an unqualified personal trainer and you get injured, you cannot claim from that instructor's insurance. Which means if you can't work, you've got no insurance to cover you. Hopefully your own personal accident insurance covers you for having a personal trainer. If it doesn't, you're going to be struggling. So that's another thing to think about. If they're not qualified, you are not covered. My motto, buy nice or buy twice. And remember, yes, you can't be experience, but experience and being qualified, I think that just makes common sense. I'm sure there's going to be a few comments from the unqualified personal trainers out there, which is fine because I will post another video just to help the educated. And we're looking at doing some nutrition videos as well coming up soon, so keep an eye on our YouTube channel. Give us a like, give us a share, and I'll see you on the next installment. Take care.